Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of the series Gender Studies. In this video, our topic is feminist movements in Pakistan. Let's start this lecture now. First of all, an overview of the topic. Pakistan is one of the countries where women are facing some issues like low literacy, early marriages, honor killing, cultural orthodoxy, etc. Such issues are prevailing in Pakistan since its inception. So after independence, elite Muslim women in Pakistan continued to advocate for reforms. They mobilized support, leading to passage of Muslim Personal Law of Sharia in 1948, which recognized a woman's right to inherit all forms of property. There was an attempt to have the government include a charter of women's rights in the 1956 constitution, but this was unsuccessful. However, the efforts continued and succeeded in the form of 1961 Muslim Family Laws Ordinance covering marriage and divorce, the most important sociological reform to have had feminist drive in Pakistan is still widely regarded as empowering to women. Now we will move ahead and we'll see various feminist movements in Pakistan throughout its history. First phase, that is 1947 to 1952. Pakistan came into being on August 14, 1947. The partition of subcontinent was basically a deadly event. People were badly affected by the partition. Muslim women were some of the most badly affected victims of partition. 75,000 women were abducted and raped during partition. So the issues for women were created just with the creation of Pakistan. Soon after partition, Fatima Jinnah formed Women's Relief Committee, which later evolved into the All Pakistan Women's Association in 1949. In short, just remember that struggle for the rights of women began just after the creation of Pakistan. This movement was being led by Fatima Jinnah, who even participated in presidential election against military dictator Ayub Khan. Fatima Jinnah was not alone in her struggle for women. In this phase, Begum Rana Liaquat Ali Khan was also side by side her. Begum Rana was wife of Liaquat Ali Khan. She played a remarkable role in settling the refugees who fled India during partition. She also organized All Pakistan Women's Association in 1949, just 2 years after the creation of Pakistan. When she noticed that there were not many nurses in Karachi, she requested the army to train women to give injections and first aid. This request resulted in paramilitary forces for women. Nursing became a career path for many girls. She continued her struggle even after her husband was assassinated in 1951 and became first woman delegate to United Nations in 1952. So this was the first wave of feminist movements in Pakistan, and you can see that how beautifully the issues of women were raised and how they were resolved. This was an ideal way of raising and resolving the issues of women. Now we will study the second wave. During 1970s, a number of Islamic countries witnessed political Islamization. Zia-ul Haq gained power in Pakistan and started Islamization in Pakistan. These reforms replaced parts of the British era Pakistan Penal Code, making adultery and fornication criminal offenses, and introduced the punishments of whipping, stoning to death, etc. Adultery and fornication are basically the terms which represent the sexual acts without marriage. So Zia-ul Haq introduced strict punishments in this regard under the tag of Islamization. Zia-ul Haq introduced the Hudood Ordinance, under which the rape victims were asked to present 4 eyewitnesses for their claims to be accepted. If a woman who accuses a man of rape cannot prove to the judicial system that she was raped, then she faces adultery charges, which means that if woman failed in proving that she was raped, then she was to face punishments which were devised for the illegal sexual acts. In order for a rapist to receive had under hudud ordinance, the maximum punishment provided for under Quran, either the rapist must confess to the rape or 4 pious adult Muslim men must witness the act of penetration and testify against the rapist. In short, it was very difficult for women to prove that they were raped. Due to the implementation of such laws during the era of Shia, a number of women faced difficulties. Here we will include the case study of Jihan Mina. In 1983, a 13-year-old orphan girl, Jihan Mina, was allegedly raped by her uncle and his sons. She was unable to provide enough evidence that she was raped. She was charged with adultery and court considered her pregnancy as proof of adultery. She was awarded the tazir, which is the punishment of 100 lashes and 3 years of rigorous punishment. So these were the circumstances which were being faced by the woman during the Zia era and even after him. Resistance against Zia. Feminist movements in Pakistan opposed such implementation of Islam by Ziaul Haq, which was they believed to be an archaic understanding of Islamic literature, asking instead for liberal modernist interpretations. Feminists formed Women's Action Forum, that is WAF, in 1981. In this way, women became active against the policies of Ziaul Haq. Now we will study feminist movement in Pakistan after Zia, that is 1988 to 2008. At the end of Zia's rule, Pakistan elected its first woman Prime Minister, Benazir Bhutto. So it was a positive sign for feminists of that particular time because they had got their direct voice in the form of Benazir Bhutto. Remarkable steps were taken for women during the era of Benazir Bhutto, like founding of all women police stations and appointing of female judges first time. Research culture was promoted during Benazir Bhutto time. Researches were produced for raising the political voice of women, sexual and reproductive rights of women, etc. So this was basically a golden era for women because all the policies of Zia were being challenged and were being changed. Women Protection Bill 2006. The norm for soft policies towards women set by Benazir Bhutto kept on flourishing with the passage of time. However, a remarkable step was taken in this regard in 2006. National Assembly of Pakistan passed the Women Protection Bill on November 15, 2006 to amend the Hudood Ordinance of Ziaul Haq. Critics of Hudood Ordinance alleged that it made exceptionally difficult and dangerous to prove allegation of rape, and thousands of women had been imprisoned as a result of this bill. So the Women Protection Bill basically returned number of offenses from the Zina Ordinance to the Pakistan Penal Code where they had been before 1979, and created entirely a new set of procedure. The law meant women would not be jailed if they were unable to prove the rape, and allows rape to be proved on grounds other than witnesses such as forensic and DNA evidence. So Women Protection Bill was a remarkable step towards the rights of women in Pakistan, and this bill was a great success of feminists of that particular time. 2008 to present. Feminist movements in Pakistan entered into a crucial period after 2008 with the advent of media channels and social media. Movements gained momentum as women were increasingly able to share their ideas and beliefs. Aurat March now held in numerous cities across the country every year. These marches demand political space for women, safety for women and transgenders, end of violence against women, and such other rights. However, these marches have become controversial due to the way of their conduct. Resultantly, these marches are not being proven fruitful for the women of Pakistan. Instead, they go against them. So this was all about feminist movements in Pakistan throughout the history of the country. This was all from today's lecture. Thanks for watching this video. Like, share, subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon for more videos. Goodbye.